Here's a little part of it.
Okay.
It's Friday. Gotta get down on Friday. Everybody's looking forward to the weekend.
Weekend twice? Wait a minute.
What do you think?
Wait, have I
heard that before? Yeah, okay. So a couple years ago, this girl known to me named Rebecca Black stole my lyrics.
She stole them?
Yeah.
Those were yours?
Straight from my MySpace page.
She took them?
Yeah. And I think the song had a ton of potential, but she put it to terrible music. She took my lyrics.
Yeah, we need my lyrics.
Here.
Right.
Put it with music that's here. So I thought maybe we could put it to a different tune.
Except for like a popular tune, like Miley Cyrus or something?
Maybe like a Kanye West kind of beat.
Kanye, everybody likes Bieber. No, wait, no. We can't condone incarceration.
No. I'm thinking, I see a lot of like old people out here.
Yeah, multi-generational connection.
Miss Heater,
yeah.
Miss Heater's in the house.
Right.
Mr. Johnson's in the back.
Oh, true.
Brew Baker, Mrs.
Yeah. No, but we can't go Cyrus or Bieber, Kanye. What's connection? The Beatles?
The Beatles.
Everybody loves the Beatles.
The Beatles.
Right? Something happy, happy. Hey Jude? Would that fit the Friday, tomorrow, yesterday then?
Yes,
yeah.
Let's do it!
Alright, well, let's see what we got here.
Tickle the pearly whites, Mr. Brooks. Okay, let's see if you can get this. Give me a...
What do you want?
Give me the note.
I think it was originally an F. You want an F?
Give me a G
from
an F.
Okay, something like here.
Give me the F. That's the F.
How about this?
It's Friday. Gotta get down on Friday. Everybody, looking forward to the weekend. It's Friday. Get down on Friday. Everybody's looking forward to the weekend.
That was actually really bad news, Bears.
Yeah. You know what's good news?
Good news?
What's good news?
What's that?
Live from CHS!
It's Friday night and Carroll's got talent! Give it up!
All right, let's welcome our hosts, Mr. Houston and Mrs. Greenwood.
Thank you very much. Carroll's Lieutenant Greenwood, I appreciate the session. The best part about the dark is there's a lack of light. Wow! What a gorgeous looking crowd and smart too! You're welcome. I'm Steve Pearson, this is Helen Brubaker, and we are opening and we're actually the second act. We didn't open at all. And anyway, this evening there is a ton of student talent. I'm amazed. I'm looking at this roster going, student, and I am very impressed by our student body and those who tried out. The fact that this is an entirely student body show is also impressive on that. I'm not sure why the visitors were up here, because I was told it was students only.
It is really student only.
I thought so, because I tried to audition and they never called me back.
No. Probably not.
But if Mr. Taylor and there's Mr. Deckard coming up, I think...
got a few surprises tonight.
I can put something together.
You know,
I can do it real fast.
There is hope.
There are 22 acts. I could be 9.5.
Can we fit him in at 9.5?
It's really only worth a half. Wait, Lowry. Okay, without further ado, let's get the other two students and give me time to get my act together.
Amber Peterson, say something. You can go work on your act then.
Thank you. Thank you. cheated myself. We were in Jamaica.
Why?
Because they won't let
me in. Won't let you in it? Why don't they let you in it?
I brought my bowls and power tools and I still can't get in the show.
It seems just a little lax. There must be something else. Like, I mean, you could sing some, you could do something simpler, like sing a song or.
I don't know to carry a tune.
See, I knew that you had some other talent you could do. See, I.
Sing a song.
Cool, like me and my brother. I didn't mean that, I just meant that you could find.
You're here, and I'm here. I can get on my track phone, it'll take a while to get the internet, but I can look up the lyrics to any song you want to sing. What's the song you want to sing?
I mean, I already have a song with.
Good, you already have one!
Yeah, but I'm singing.
Now you have a part for me. Let's name a song.
It's called I Wonder by Leland.
I Wonder
by Leland.
Yeah, but. I feel like we have to get the
reception.
Okay.
Okay. to ask Mr. Decker with Your Love Is.
And then following that will be Ashley Frucci with Crazy For You.
I'm not afraid. Everybody is mine. Thank you.
sorry. Next up, actually busting a move up here is Raul Garza. Give it up.
Thank you. adult with half a brain. You can see that humankind has been sane. To the point where I don't know about upset the status quo. I throw poison in the water main. Listen close to everybody's heart and hear that breaking sound. Hopes and dreams are shattering apart and crashing to the ground. I cannot believe my eyes, how the world's filled with filth and lies. But it seems to me, evil inside of me lives on the run.
Look around, we're living with the loss.
Thank you. for a treat. Up next is Mallory Ginder, Mrs. Summers, and Mr. Taylor singing Red by Taylor Swift. Give it up.
Jordan Chewood and Zach Honeycutt. performance is dedicated to Britney's people.
Good evening, and thank you for joining us. I'm Chris Banks. Now we begin tonight with the newscast.
And Fountain of Latoya, that's right.
Sorry, that's my partner, Lynn Latoya. Now we begin tonight with
the newscast. Thank you for joining us.
Sorry, thank them for joining us, Lynn.
You find some ropes to have them get to.
Newscasts are harder than people think.
There's preparation. production, and of course, the impending threat of being kidnapped live on air.
Breaking news.
By Tim Koshenberger.
So, thank you for joining us. We begin tonight with a story out of Detroit. A gang is going to have to wait 90 days if it wants to commit any more crimes. We go live on air with Phil Filson.
Well, Bruce, that pretty much sums it all up. The gang was busted. Back to you.
To me, Ron, play back.
Phil, you have a minute 20.
Okay, well, Bruce, in that case, the spot where I'm standing is very calm, very peaceful, but if you had been standing here about 4 hours ago, it still would have been this calm and peaceful, you see. That's because this isn't actually the spot where the gang was busted, but in fact, 6 blocks that way. My prediction, everlasting peace in the city of Detroit. Okay, well, thank you, Phil. We have breaking news now in the city of Livonia. Police are on the scene of a shooting and a robbery at a gas station. Police have no leads at this time, but they're telling us that the suspect is a lot like Bruce Banks.
No, I told you before the show, no!
I'm just saying, Bruce, if the shoe fits and it cracks, it's probably a duck.
What does that even mean?
Bruce, it's just a question.
How could it have been me? I've been with you the entire time!
Just admit it, Bruce. Guys, I'm gonna try to keep my calm here. Try not to explode! But can somebody please tell me what was wrong with that newscast?
Tom, can I speak to you for a moment?
Yeah, guys, just give me 2 seconds with him, see.
No, I didn't mean to pull you away. I just wanted to tell you that, well, you're fired.
What?
Oops, I guess that does pull you away.
Yeah, just a little bit. 2 years of faithful service, this new station, and this is how it ends. I'm fired nonchalantly in front of my whole news team.
Of course not. Everybody, for he's a jolly fellow. Security, everyone, I want you to meet Andrew Mando. I interviewed him 5 minutes ago, and he seems like a man for the job. Remember, Andrew, where's my Friday?
Yes, of course. Now, are there any questions?
How long have you been in the business?
That is a very good question. No, I'm not.
Are you going to answer my question?
You see, you've already asked your question, so let's give the others a chance. Now, shall we? Yes.
What did First by Friday mean in reference to us?
Yes, well, I single-handedly am going to make you the number one news station in Detroit no later than the 6th day of this week.
How is that possible? We haven't been number one in 10 years.
Yes, well, big changes are coming. So, chins up and get pumped, people, because I'm going to make you number one. Now, if you excuse me, I have some business to attend to. Yes. I'm the news director now, and I'm more determined than ever to make this news station number one. There will be no more slow.
Good for you, sir.
And who are you?
Well, I'm the kidnapper you hired, sir.
Oh, well, you see. You don't look like the guy in the picture the criminal agency sent me.
Yeah, Lex. You see, they sent me instead. Lex actually got kidnapped last night. All right, huh? Don't you worry. I got eyes in the back of my head. I'm not getting kidnapped anytime soon.
Yes, well. Just listen. Tomorrow morning, I'm going to kidnap one of our reporters live on air. Just to be safe, take him 500 miles north, roughly, and drop him off there for about 1 week.
Yeah, take him 5 feet north and chop him off.
100.
Yeah, take him 500 feet north and chop him off.
Miles.
What?
Miles.
What? Oh, Miles! You see, that's my last name, Miles.
Just take him 500 miles north and there.
Miles is in my name or Miles is in the
name?
job tomorrow.
I don't trust you anymore, you're fired.
No, 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 it's I do. Besides, all the other kidnappers at the agency are booked for a solid month.
Don't screw this up.
Good evening, and thank you for joining us. I'm Grace James.
And that one
don't try to say your name, Lynn. We have breaking news in the city of Waterford Township. We go live on air with Bill Filson.
Well, of Bruce, the first good news. When I arrived today, I learned it wasn't actually a four-alarm fire. In fact, it can't... I'm in the middle of a light out here.
Nobody knew, or your beloved, Kim Filson, gets it.
Oh, yeah. It's actually Phil Filson. Penis.
What about the H?
It's silent as well.
So your name is L. Elston.
Well, no, the H combined. Say
what? That makes no sense. Why don't you just spell your name with an F? Never mind. Listen up, Detroit. I'm kidnapping your beloved P.L.P. Elston until 9 minutes from back. I want $1 million and a helicopter.
Helicopter? You're gonna mess up the morning commute.
Well, that may be, but remember, Chuckle, and I need to stop him.
Well, you can stop providing compelling live video, kidnapping me live on air.
Well, that's not happening.
Okay, well then, fine. You need to sign off.
Like hell, I've never done that before.
Let me do it for you. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Phil Filson, reporting to you live from the campfire. Bruce Lynn, back to you. Okay. Well, up next, could your watch machine be stealing your identity? Ooh, not so surprising answer straight ahead. Phil? Yeah, that's me, answering.
How did you escape?
Well, it was the weirdest thing. The kidnapper just took me, like, 50 miles north and put me in a hotel and left. He put you in a hotel? Yeah, it was really weird. I just called my wife, told her I'd be able to like today, that's all. Yes, well, Phil, don't call anyone anymore. We'll announce it, but let's wait till 11 o'clock news, shall we?
Well, what do we tell people at 6? That he's still missing?
Yes, actually, I like that. At day 7, Filson gone. Police losing hope and telling news is not giving up until they see a corpse. Now, everyone's dismissed. Hello, and welcome to Channeling News. My name is Linda Toya, and I'm Bruce Banks.
I'm Bruce Banks.
We have some breaking news now. Bruce. I'll tell him shit to me.
What about the other breaking news?
Well, this is as breaking news as it's been here.
Then we should just read the telephone.
Fine. We have some lesser breaking news now to take a choice. Meg, help me say about that very latest. Meg.
Rips, Len. I'm standing by the line. For in moments, the man who unleashed the tiger during one of my live shots is going to be escorted to another cave. But instead of being shot with bullets of pure lead, he'll be shot with bullets of pure justice. Oh, here it comes. Tim, would you please explain to these people why you had a tiger released during one of my live shots? You really believe that? It was Andrew Lando. Ha! Tiger.
A tiger? Does this look like a tiger to you?
See, this proves I'm innocent.
No way. Said I'm not a person, I'm a monster.
What kind of monster carries a gun?
Okay, fine, a man in a monster mask. Now, are there any last words?
Any last words? What is this, a western?
So long.
Yes!
My mask! I mean, yes, my very realistic homemade Andrew Lando mask that I obviously made to frame him.
Impersonating a news director, will ya? And I suffered a non-fatal gunshot to my forearm. And you police officers, what are you even doing? Arrest this man!
Why don't you not tell us how to do our job? This isn't over!
Well, thank you for joining us. I'm Bruce Banks.
And I'm Bruce Banks. Good night, y'all.